If any NGO wants to have investment from your group, then what kind of steps that NGOs needs to be taken in this respect? Is there any formal proposal, project which they have to submit it to you?
Common philosophy is really making investments in for-profit businesses. But this doesn't mean that that you know, strictly we are not looking at non-profits, because nowadays we see that non-profits are also getting very particular about you know, their financial returns. You know, they're commercializing their model in such a way that there is transparency and accountability to their donors. So we, you know, in India we haven't actively looked at non-profit funding, but if there is a potential opportunity in, you know, the areas that we focus on, which is you know, healthcare or energy, housing, agriculture and water, and we feel like this is you know, this could become a business model that will be financially sustainable, you know, basically satisfies all our criteria, then we'll consider making an investment. But before, optically, we don't make an investment in the non-profit itself. We'll have to either create, you know, another entity that will allow us to make this investment. And the process is actually pretty straightforward. So once we hear of a lead, or, you know, we speak with the entrepreneurs of this business, you know, we have an initial conversation with them. They know more about how Acumen operates, and then they submit a business plan to us. A business plan of their operations, you know, any prior data that they have in terms of over the last couple of years, how they've been running. And then based on that, we take it ahead and, you know, then the deal goes into sort of a formal due diligence once we're convinced that this is something that we will consider. So there isn't a form or anything, but we're very sort of particular about receiving that business plan and, you know, analyzing it and seeing whether it fits the Acumen Fund criteria.
Do you evaluate and monitor the work after your investment?
Yeah. So that's actually a big part of our of Acumen's, you know, value add and role. Just the beginning of the relationship once the investment is made, because there is a whole lot of work that we do with the company, you know, to help them either expand, you know, launch a new product, look at you know, new sort of acquisitions in terms of government tenders and all of that. Actually, that's called post investment management, and it's basically helping the company you know, run their operations, expand the reach to people, as well as figure out things like, you know, what are the kind of people they need to hire, you know, what is their corporate governance policies like. So all of these things we get involved with as much as possible and help them, you know, understand firstly what is available. We'll even, you know, introduce them to people who we might know in our network that they might be able to you know, approach in terms of services and stuff. So yes, there is a very large engagement that happens even after investment is actually made. And additionally, what we do is every month, as well as every quarter, we get reports from our investees about, you know, what their financial performance is like, what is their operational, you know, what are the challenges they are facing. So it's, you know, like a marriage between us and our investees.